outcomes our Hamiza should deliver. So the challenge for the mission is to ensure that. So with this, I think thank you.
For Yogita and Manik for this session, before we move to the next session, any issues?
Entrepreneurial in there, or they don't have land, or they don't have productive assets. How do you bring those people out of poverty through this model?
So you would like me to reply,
or any CRT reply? We have done something there.
Yeah, anywhere.
So
should I
frame it in Hindi? Point is that each one has their own ideas of what to do next. Doesn't matter whether you have land, don't have land. Everyone, they know what to do. That you can be, I can guarantee you that. Everybody knows. They are illiterate, but they have dreams. And they know, and when we start the program, we tell them that, imagine there are 7 steps to, you know, bringing paradise on earth. That's how we start. So what is the first step you would like to take? And they figure out. This is, you know, we don't have to do anything. They know, somebody will say, my child is hungry, first I'll treat that. So there could be emergencies. And everybody is tremendously entrepreneurial. We don't have to think that enterprise comes from MBAs or everybody is entrepreneurial. You would have seen, Fakirama has not spoken, but she and her husband were actually manual scavengers. But from there, by taking steps, she's built 3 houses now, children have done, one child has done MBA, daughter-in-law is also MBA. So, first thing, that's what Yogita has been telling you. The biggest battle is your own mindset. They know what has to be done. They just want those obstacles to be removed. Each one has his own plan. There are absolutely landless poor, they take lands on lease. Which, it's not difficult at all. And I have not seen the case. Each one, woman from Jharkhand, ladies from Jharkhand will tell you next what they have done. So each one has a plan. There is, that doubt you need not have.
This example, we can, just a small example. Like let us say, no, Hamida's federation is just some 6-month-old federation. They had a similar case of a girl called Mashal. So she, very poor, and there's a lot of age difference between the husband and wife. So total and abject poverty. So one day they only decided, now we have to think about what to do with the family. So a lot of discussion. So end result is that the members themselves contributed 12,000 rupees, then forced the elder brother to part away a land for the younger brother. So now with the 1,200, she has purchased some 2 goats. And now by pressurizing the BDO, they have got an IAY house for them. Why I'm saying this is, actually you leave all this, we should leave all these things to the poor. And whenever any officer trainee has a doubt, you ask the community what is the answer of this. You will get not only one, but you will get 10 best answers. Believe in the community, they will deliver.
Ma'am, on our village visit to a village in UP, we noticed that the self-help groups were based on caste lines. So the very poor women in the village were not really aware of how to go about organizing themselves. And the women of the upper caste who actually formed a self-help group were reluctant to make them a member of their own group. So how do you break across these lines?
See, whenever we, yeah, we can take one more question.
Oh.
Can you believe that what the students have said?
Yes, sir. So I actually was in tears when I was hearing the story, because this is something which you really hear on from childhood you hear these stories, and it's very real. So a question which I would like to ask is, to maintain the sustainability of this kind of a scheme, so how do we ensure that the people repay the loan that they have taken? And what do you give any time period or time limit for them to repay? And if it is not, then what is the case?
3, 1, 2. The last two before we go to the next one. And I can make up, because Nikita has spoken, I find that only women officers are responding. Good.
So I can make out, as Divya said, the financial services and access to the market part of this whole movement has been strong enough, as I said. But these last mile delivery of public services and the access to the entitlements, which makes the SHGs the nucleus of intervention at the village, how do we propose to enable a convergence, because this would lead to a lot of convergence between so many departments and might lead to a structural discomfort between many departments. How do we propose to ease out all those difficulties?
Like you made institutions to bring these people, we also think about institutions to get the market linkage, the products or services that they make. How do you get that to the market? I mean, is there a thought about making institutions in each block or at the district level, so that, you know, the other front end linkages are also happening?
See, first I'll club your questions. See, social mobilization has 7 firm steps. In fact, you can write it. These are the 7 fundamental things which will come one after the other. And I'm sure you'll get answer in those 7 steps. Step 1 for social mobilization and NRLM per se is identification of the poor, number 1. You have to identify the poor, that is the most important thing. IAY kisko dena hai? First you identify the poor. It should not go to a non-poor. So step 1 is identification of the poor. So while we form groups also, we should ensure that the poorest of the poor and the most vulnerable are not left out. That is why I had put in a slide that why the poorest of poor should always be in the focus. Many schemes start for the poor, but somewhere down implementing, we see what these are the guidelines, the contractor should not come. You know, we actually go to some other pathway and we forget the pivotal part, the poor in it. So step 1 is identify the poor. Step 2 is to organize the poor into self-help groups. We have spoken a lot. Step 3 is to have facilitation and training of this poor by any external agency. This is the step 3. So step 3, hope, are understood by the statement itself. So this has to come one after the other. If you say, we will not identify the poor, but sabko group bana denge, that will not help. So after this, third step is the fourth step. That is, you have to show a pathway of capital. A path to capital you have to show them. But straight away you will not jump with the credit linkage. First part is their own saving. So that in the small saving, they have the confidence that even if I take 500, in fact, we have a CRP here who took 100 rupee loan. And you will actually, you know, you will laugh away taking 100 rupee loan. But a poor is so scared. Like Pratinisa was saying, some 5,000 came, but she took only 500 rupees. So the path of the capital, step 1 is their own saving. Let them take small amounts, repay it, they have the confidence that they can have a small livelihood. Maybe perhaps 2 hen, something, a small livelihood. Step 2 is then the fund which goes to the group. Like we say, revolving fund of 15,000 rupees. So they do, again they repay it back, they do the livelihood. Step 3 is then again CIF, that is about 40 to 50,000. Once their creditworthiness for a period of 6 to 8 months is ensured, then you bring the credit linkage. And then you open the capital for them. Having ensured that, you know, the creditworthiness, then the group on its own power, like she was saying, the bankers now in fact are calling and asking them, when will you take the credit loan? So that is the step 4. What is the step 5? Then you show them the path to a livelihood. Because it is a national rural livelihood mission, so livelihood is the main focus, but not the first step. So once these 4 steps of institutional building, foundation, showing them path to capital, you open a path for a livelihood. Then what is the step 6 and 7? Then 6th step, as you say, is convergence of the government scheme. We realize that the majority of the expenditure of the government of India is basically on the schemes which hit the poor. The most, you know, if you see what we, the government of India spends on health and education is the major chunk. And what the poor spends as an expenditure is again health and education. How contradictory it is. So that means then the step six will be converging the government schemes as an entitlement to the step of the poor, to the doorsteps of the poor. How it will happen is that these platforms will then pressurize, like as I told, to bring IEY, to bring NREGA, and it is happening. So this is the sixth step. Then the seventh step is giving them what we call a suraksha kavach. That is, you insure their livestock, you insure their assets, you insure pension, you insure the insurance sector goes to them. So once the first four steps come, naturally the seventh and the last step, as I told you, will come. So right now I'm sure, you know, these things will double. Even when we gave a revolving fund to the tune of 2 crore to the self-help groups of Srinagar. So as you say, market linkages. She on her own, Hamida, has brought a shawl, sorry, Rubina. She has stitched, that brand embroidery, and she has sold also in the market. So these are the steps which will come one after the other, and slowly, seamlessly, the things take place. But nevertheless, once that critical mass is there, then again, somebody has to facilitate them into some cooperative, giving them some more market spaces, slowly and steadily. But that will definitely come. But for now, let us stick to these seven basic steps of eradicating poverty. Yeah. See, that is what. The social agenda is actually a part of the seven steps. So then they take the issue from social agenda. But yes, you are right. See, even in this self-help group movement, we don't tinker. We don't say, aap banaiye, aap banaiye. Slowly it will be eradicated. I can tell you of one example in UP in which the so-called one caste would not allow the other caste to wear chappal in front of their houses. Then the village organization, including all the caste put together, they decided, ye bahut ho gaya, nothing more. Today all 600 women group will wear their chappal and they will spin around the Thakur's house throughout the day. So then came an end to that practice. So they have the power in them. The only thing is that you have to ensure, we have to ensure that we give, that kind of an ambience to blossom their flower, as I said.
I think the important thing is the sensitive facilitation. If you take the last step first, then this whole movement can collapse. So you have to be careful. As and when their strength multiplies, then their ability to influence the rest of the system improves. So it's not just our issuing diktats. It doesn't have to stop at the PDO level or some other level. It won't get delivered. The seven-step pedagogy is so important that you don't... I remember one of my friend mentioned about failures. So one of the things was that, some of the project officers, young officers like you, they said banks se bahut deri ho raha hai narega payment ke liye, to hum VO se dilwayenge. So in the tribal areas, so VO ko paisa de diya aur all of them got wages very fast. And we also were very happy. Then we said, okay, let us do it across the state. Then the caste rivalries, the political rivalries, there were complaints against us that they are supporting the ex-party and the ruling party is not getting any benefit. Then there were people who wanted to split the village organization, saying that it is, not in favor of the ruling party. So this backlash also can happen. So that's one case where we burnt our fingers. Then we withdrew that. We said, okay, we don't want the institutions to suffer. So there will be a lot of temptation to the failure of the government to somehow be rectified by the group phenomenon. So you have to be very careful there. So it seems the easy thing, theek hai, wo bano se bana dete hain, midday meals, SSGs ko de diya, no training, nothing, no resources given to them, and they all become benami. And then the blame is on the SSGs. So what is the kind of capacitation that you have done to enable them to handle this? So this is very important. Your question about marketing, it is happening many places, but what we found, I actually went, that's another failure also. So I first wanted to go into marketing. Then I was very happy, my women groups had made a lot of money in Red Gram marketing, I'm talking about 12-13 years ago. And I went to them. I said, yes, we made a lot of money. But do you know how much we spent on pesticides, fertilizers? So we are actually incurred a loss. And that set me thinking into how can we have low-cost agriculture. It was a lecture from those women that then I realized that we need to look at the backward side. So we said, okay, how do you reduce riskiness in agriculture? How do you make it more profitable by working on the backward side? So I still don't think that they are that strong to get into this. But there are models in various states. Who is from Jharkhand and MP. So there is a very good model by Pradhan where they worked on the poultry, where the women have, they manage the poultry themselves. They are doing very well. But they worked on it for about 10, 15 years. So it takes a lot of effort. It doesn't happen automatically. I remember many of my young friends, district collectors, now they are secretaries in the state government. They said, sir, hum achha branding karenge SSG products ka. और वो तो आईआईटी आईएम से था, आई कुड नॉट आर्ग्यू विद हिम. मैंने बोला भैया करो. तो उसने क्या, वो चला नहीं. फिर दूसरे कलेक्टर ने बोला, सर मैं एसएचजी के प्रोडक्ट सब वेब पे बेचूंगा. अरे ठीक है यार, बेचो. बट देन इट वाज नॉट सस्टेनिंग. बट दिस ऑल दिस एफर्ट्स टेक प्लेस. बट प्लीज रिमेंबर द स्पीड इज नॉट योर स्पीड. इट इज नॉट योर कैपेबिलिटी. It is their capability. Initially it may be slow, but after some time it will exceed your ability. Mm. You can't even catch up. So we have to understand when to intervene, when not to intervene. So that's also important, and how to intervene. So we come to the end of...
It's a financial repayment.
Yeah.
No, you raised the question of how they repay, how they ensure and all. My understanding is normally a poor woman, when they accept the first loan, they have to justify to the group. They go and talk to the group, this much money I need. If you have heard Jane Katin, they said, paisa nahi dete, fir jaake check bhi karenge, aapne kya kiya. There is always the collectively, collectively they don't follow actually. And the bank loan also, normally they start with the livelihood about which they have knowledge of. For example, Taj Nishra Krishi, she said, my husband, he went to Karnool, collected some, bulk wholesale mein kareeda. They assess the risk. If it fails, what is the risk I am supposed to take? So they have the innate, knowledge about what they are entering into. If you push money without this capacity or stage-wise, you are going to make them, get into debt, basically. You push them 5 lakh, 50,000 without telling them how to spend that. You are going to make them debt-ridden, not out of poverty, basically. And if you are, and I noticed Taj Nisha when she said, I have taken 8 lakhs. She was not so proud about it. But she paused and again said, I repaid that. That is where she gets the pride. I have successfully managed 8 lakhs rupees. I have repaid. So that happens. Only thing is, if you push things fast, it may not happen. Let the family take money, repay it, feel comfortable about it, then the next may take 5,000, 3,000, 15,000. They also see avenues opening for them. So it's a step-by-step process. So repayment, other thing when you say, is there any pressure? Normally the repayment is decided by the group. Imagine again, somebody has taken 5,000 rupee loan for 10 installments and the family will meet with an accident. So the group actually recognizes that. Aap is mahine nahi dena hai, aap do mahine ke baad shuru kar dijiye. So that understanding is in the community. That's why we say affinity group. And the group supports each other. So things happen.
No, that's very important what Manik said, and that is what distinguishes this model from the Bangladesh model, which is very famous, the Grameen Bank model. And based on the Grameen Bank model, you have a huge MFI industry in India, which has led to, in my opinion, ruination of a lot of poor families. This is patient capital. The MFI is an impatient capital. And what Manik said is very important. If something fails, the group recognizes that it didn't happen it didn't happen because they don't want to repay. There's a real problem. They support the member again. I've seen cases where one enterprise failed, second enterprise failed, third enterprise, also the group said, okay, no, please go ahead and do it. We want your life to improve. So they wait for them to improve their life. So that is the what distinguishes this from the microfinance industry. So can we continue or you want a break, Venkat? Okay, sure. 5 minute break, please.
My presentation, the other
test. Oh, okay. Yeah, 5 minute break, please. Yeah, he has to face.